Hello and welcome to Mitchell's World. Today we're going to be building a video game controller stand based off of Friday the 13th, the movie, and the game. Let's get building. And for this build, the way I started was I just got a scrap piece of wood that doesn't really matter what thickness that you make it. I just had a scrap wood that just worked out. But you could make this with any real thickness that you want. You could even make it with foam board if you prefer. And it's also easier to use foam board if you don't have the tools such as a bandsaw and a drill press or a drill. So you can do that easy peasy. For this sign part, I cut that out on a bandsaw, as well as the axe handle and the axe head. So this sign is supposed to look similar to the sign that actually hangs out in front of campsite of Camp Crystal Lake, where the Friday the 13th movies actually took place, and the game as well. And I'm a big fan of the game, that's why I made this. But for the lettering of the actual sign in the movie, I was trying to do it with paint, but the paint was just not working out. And I also wanted to do the stylistic red on the sides of the sign, but it just wasn't going to look that great the way I was doing it. So I actually found some stickers for the lettering, which made it way easier instead of actually painting, because I'd have to do two coats at least to make it thick enough to where you could see, or not see through it, I should say. But once I did that, I was really happy I used the stickers instead. But obviously before that, I painted it yellow, and I had to do a lot of coats with it because yellow, I just kept on seeing through it, and I kept on seeing the wood grain. Now that was annoying. I had to do 5 coats with this yellow. But for the base, which is the ground, I just did 1 coat of green, and then I took a lot of different colors like brown and a real light green and slightly darker green than that, and I just slightly stroked it across, all across it, to make a ground look. Like, it, ground isn't just solid one color. So you have like the dirt and the grass, and it looks better that way. And for the axe head, I cut those out on a bandsaw, but I cut the axe head and the axe handle separate. Then once I did that, I rounded the handle completely around with the stationary belt sander. And then I rounded the axe head slightly, and then made the edge sharp with the, again, belt sand, so it looked like an axe head. And I was going to put a dowel all the way through the axe head and then through the handle, but it just, when I tried drilling it, it was started to break the handle, so I decided not to. But I still drilled through the axe head and then put a small dowel and painted a small line that looks like a nail, like they have an actual axe head, just for the aesthetic purposes of it. And then I also drilled into the sign so that it could stand up. I originally was just gonna glue it right to the bottom, or right to the base itself, but I didn't like how that was looking, so I just thought making it stand would look cool. And then I can cover the drill holes with little rocks, so it kinda, well, looks good aesthetically, and, well, overall just kinda cool, and fits the theme. And for the little pieces of wood I have here, I just went in my backyard and I actually found just some sticks, and I cut them on the bandsaw, and for the little stick that the axe is actually going through, I took a chisel and just hammered it near the middle of the center of it, and then it split it, and then I could easily just glue it onto the base and then put the axe head into it, and it held really well. I also put a little bit of glue on the end of the handle here so that it would stick to the sign. And for these little pieces here, I just wanted it to look like Jason just chopped a piece of wood in half. So I put these little two pieces here and glued them on, and they also keep it to where the controller is supported better instead of just dangling on this little axe handle. And whoop, and don't make it fall either. Don't drop it like I just did. But overall, this project, I spent the whole day yesterday just tinkering with it and playing with little designs and such, but it worked really well. I was real happy with it. I was thinking of aging this sign here, but I just like it. It just pops. And like I say, it's getting me pumped for the update on the Friday the 13th game, which, if you didn't hear yet, they're gonna have Space Jason, or Jason X, which is gonna be so cool, and they're gonna have the space map that I'm super stoked for. So I just really wanted to make this in preparation of my hypeness for this game. And also, I don't have anything to hold my controller. I just kind of put it on the ground. So now I have one. And also, too, just a reminder, before I painted any of this, I did file and sand quite a bit. Make sure that you get all those saw marks out. And I mean, I know it's self-explanatory, but, you know, sometimes you keep on going and you miss small little details like that. But other than that, I mean, just play with it and come up with some cool ideas. I'm sure you will. This is just a base to what you can figure out, what your imagination can lead you. And as a side note as well, when you're cutting those sticks, be very careful, because since it's not flush with the table, it can turn and get caught into the bandsaw. I had an experience with that. Thankfully, my hand wasn't close to the saw blade. Make sure you keep your hand a very good distance away, especially when you work with like wood like that, that's not even. You have to be extremely careful. As always, thank you very much for watching, and please leave a like and subscribe, and leave a comment, and just let me know. Do you think this is cool? Do you like it? Do you want to make one similar? Do you have any ideas of what you want me to do next? And again, thank you so much for watching. Have a good one.